Greetings, fellow spokespeople. Kirsten here, coming to you with purple hair in support of two of my grade 4 girls who've organized a fundraising activity to raise money for people living with cancer. Our question this week is, where do I think education is going in the next 5 years? And I have so much to say about it, I hardly know where to start. I think education will remain the contested issue that it is right now in terms of what purposes we believe education should be serving and how best to achieve those goals, and in terms of our understanding of how people learn and therefore how people should be teaching, and a whole alphabet of areas in between. I sometimes lament the fact that everyone seems to have an opinion about what it is that teachers should be doing in schools. Everyone's been to school, therefore everyone's an expert on school. And I think that this puts teachers in a really difficult situation as we try to meet the needs of all the children in our class and the diverse perspectives that their parents bring for what we should be doing. However, I ultimately don't think that this is a bad thing, as it demonstrates that people understand the importance teachers play in children's lives and their desire to engage with this process. Here in Alberta, where I teach, we're in a period of great uncertainty and unrest as we try to sign teacher contracts and school boards deal with major cuts in funding. I feel overwhelmed and I feel unsure when I contemplate what's going to be happening in school buildings across the province over the next 5 years. The prospect of larger classes, less support, less PD, and heavier workloads weighs heavily on me when I think about my desire to meet all of the needs of the children in my class. I'm not sure if this is going to be possible. I worry that I'm going to be put in a position where I have to choose between being the kind of teacher I know I can be and caring for my own family needs. And I worry that the teachers who teach my own children are going to have to be making these decisions as well. However, I also have great hope for the next 5 years. I'm encouraged by the amazing children I see coming into school each day and the potential for great things that they bring with them. I'm excited to be thinking about who I'm going to be meeting and what kind of activities of work we're going to be doing together. I'm energized by the exciting community of teachers that I've been meeting through the Twitterverse, through this fellowship, and a myriad of other ways. And I'm excited to be thinking about the ways I can continue to use technology and social media to bring high-quality educational experiences to the children that I work with. I'm hopeful and I'm engaged. I forge forth towards an undiscovered country. On a more serious note, many of the fellowship and in this blogosphere have been commenting on possibilities for education in light of the tragic events in Boston this week. And I'd like to share some of my own thoughts and questions as well. A few of you have expressed a hope and a desire that the connections children are able to make through social media and technology in the classrooms may play a positive role in creating a globalized world. And I too share your hope. But I have questions and I have concerns about this as well. To begin with, I'm unsure whether it's true that knowing more about other people necessarily leads to a better understanding or acceptance of those people, nor that understanding and accepting that there are differences in other people, in theory, leads to actual changes in actions. It sometimes seems to me that we're proposing that we will be able to create a sort of American-style melting pot, and at the same time a Canadian-style multicultural world through Twitter, Skype, and blogs. And I'm not sure if that's true or even if it's desirable. For me, so far, neither the models of melting pot nor multiculturalism have proven to be enough in the face of the diversity and differences that we live with and the complex issues that arise in light of these differences. And so for me, events like Boston demand of us as teachers that we begin to consider more carefully and thoughtfully questions around how the social semiotics of daily life and practice, the things that are both overt and hidden, children are taught to understand the world in particular ways, what those ways might be, and how it is that education has in fact not been the great redeemer of prejudices, but I think in fact has continued to give meanings to these differences. In his book Education at Empire's End, John Walensky reminds educators that we must consider more carefully how education both reflects and constructs our notions of a world divided, and our profoundly held sense of who belongs where and how we are educated and what it is that we take to be the true nature of differences. I've often been politely and sometimes not so politely teased in the staff room for being too philosophical with these kinds of questions, which is in fact a polite way of making my questions interesting, yet really irrelevant. But I persevere. Our questioning must have profound implications for our teaching practice as we experience the world alongside our students. As these questions open up possibilities for us to take up ethical questions of how to live well together so that we can flourish as humans. Hannah Arendt's notion of natality and the renewal of the world through the young reminds us that we have as teachers an obligation and a duty in the face of other. We are teachers. We are entrusted to lead and sometimes to follow young people to places that are often difficult for us to confront. Simply reducing the world to "we are all the same" is no more helpful than dualistic notions of us and them, the privileged and not so privileged, as we erase the complexity of what can flourish in the classroom and in our own world through thoughtfulness. Ultimately, I believe in light of these events, we need to strive even more to take up curriculum as a question of what it is that we should stand for in articulating possibilities for a renewal of the world other than what it is. Thanks for listening.